What if you could actually see your tinnitus? I don't mean with your eyes. I mean seeing it through cold, hard data that shows you exactly how that ringing, hissing, or buzzing is affecting your body second by second. If you have tinnitus, you know that the treatment can sometimes feel like a frustrating guessing game. It's a lot of appointments and suggestions and therapies that might work or might not. But what if we could stop the guessing? What if we could finally actually measure it? I'm Dr. Layne Garrett, founder of Timpanogos Hearing and Tinnitus, where we've specialized in treating tinnitus for over 20 years. And in this video, I'm pulling back the curtain on a new direction in tinnitus care that leverages your own biological data, things like your heart rate variability, to create treatments that are as unique as you are. The future of tinnitus relief isn't just about how you feel, it's about how we can objectively measure, track, and improve. This represents a fundamental shift on how we can fight back against tinnitus, so you're going to want to stick around. If you have tinnitus, this journey probably sounds a little too familiar. It starts with the sound, that ringing or buzzing or hissing that nobody else can hear. It might start subtly, but soon it's a constant companion. It steals your quiet moments, making it harder to focus and turns a peaceful night's sleep into a battleground. The anxiety starts to climb and you start to wonder, will this ever just go away? So finally, you make the appointment. You see a doctor or maybe an audiologist that says they can help with tinnitus. They put you in a booth, you press a button when you hear the beeps, and they confirm that you have a little bit of hearing loss, which is pretty common. Then comes the part that feels like you're hitting a brick wall. You're given a questionnaire. On a scale of 1 to 10, how much does your tinnitus bother you? How often does it interfere with your concentration? You do your best to answer, trying to average out the good days and the bad days, but how can a single number possibly capture the roller coaster of your experience? How can that represent the spike in ringing you felt during a stressful meeting or the quiet panic that washed over you last night when you were trying to fall asleep? The simple truth is, it can't. While these subjective questionnaires are useful, they are also fundamentally limited. They rely on your memory and your mood at that exact moment. They're a snapshot in time. They're not a full feature film of your life with your tinnitus. That's when frustration really can start kicking in. Because based on this limited information, you might be given some advice like, try a sound machine, or avoid salt, or worse, you hear the words that every person with tinnitus dreads. There's nothing we can do. You're just gonna have to learn to live with it. Well, you leave the clinic, you feel unheard, misunderstood, and powerless. You're on that tinnitus treadmill, running in place, trying different things, and getting nowhere. All because that approach is based on a guess, not a measurement. Let's dig into why this approach is so flawed. Why do standard treatments like hearing aids, tinnitus retraining therapy, sound generators, cognitive behavioral therapy, or advice like reducing stress work for some people, but do almost nothing for others? Because we've been looking at tinnitus through a very narrow lens. For decades, it was treated mainly as an ear problem. But we now know tinnitus isn't in your ears. It's a complex dance between your ears, your brain, and crucially, your nervous system. Let's talk about something called the autonomic nervous system now. Think of it as your body's automatic control center. It has two main branches. First, the sympathetic nervous system, your fight or flight response. This kicks in when you're under stress. Your heart rate climbs, muscles tense, you're on high alert. The second branch is the parasympathetic nervous system, your rest and digest response. This is your state of calm and recovery. In a healthy system, these two branches stay in a dynamic balance, but for many people with severe tinnitus, this system gets stuck on high alert. Scientific research shows that tinnitus distress is linked to an overactive sympathetic nervous system. Your body basically interprets the phantom sound, that ringing or buzzing, as a constant threat, keeping you in a perpetual state of fight or flight. And that is the core of the problem. Your tinnitus isn't just a sound. It's a physiological state of stress your body is trapped in. The ringing is the alarm bell, but the fire is an overstimulated nervous system. So when treatments only focus on covering up the alarm bell, they're ignoring the fire. It's like trying to fix a noisy car engine by turning up the radio. How can we expect to calm a system if we have no way of measuring its state of alarm? We've been fighting in the dark, but that's finally starting to change. What if we could flip on the lights and objectively measure the state of alarm in your nervous system? That's exactly where the future of tinnitus treatment is heading. It centers around a powerful biomarker called heart rate variability, or HRV. Now, I'm not talking about your heart rate, how many times your heart beats per minute. I'm talking about the tiny millisecond variations in time between each of your heartbeats. You might think that a steady, metronome-like heartbeat is a sign of good health, but it's actually the opposite. A healthy, resilient nervous system is adaptable, and that adaptability is reflected in a high HRV. A high HRV means there's a healthy bounce between beats, showing strong balance between your fight or flight and rest and digest systems. A low HRV, on the other hand, suggests your system is stuck in stress mode, rigid and inflexible. And here's the groundbreaking connection. A growing body of research, including a new study out of the University of Michigan, is showing a strong correlation between higher tinnitus distress and lower heart rate variability. It's a potential physiological signature of the toll tinnitus is taking on your body. It offers the first objective ways to measure the impact of tinnitus that goes far beyond that subjective questionnaire. While it's not yet a standard diagnostic tool in most clinics, Timpanogos Hearing and Tinnitus is proud to be among the first modern tinnitus specialty centers utilizing this next-level approach to care. So how does it work? Instead of just relying on subjective questionnaires and hearing tests, we also monitor biometrics. Using non-invasive wearable technology like an Apple iWatch or a Fitbit, we can track your HRV throughout the day. We're not just getting a snapshot anymore. We're getting the whole movie of your life. We can see how your nervous system responds when you're sleeping, when you're working, or when your tinnitus just feels the most severe. We can finally see those invisible patterns, allowing us to move beyond guessing and start building a truly personalized treatment plan based on your unique physiology. Real quick, if you could do me a favor, I'd appreciate it. If this video is helping you, please hit the like button. It tells YouTube that this is worth sharing with others who are struggling with tinnitus. And while you're at it, hit the subscribe button and turn on notifications so you never miss another one of our educational videos. Thanks. Now let me tell you a patient's experience. I'm going to call him David. David was a 55-year-old accountant, and his tinnitus was wrecking his focus at work and his ability to relax at home. He'd visited other physicians and other audiologists, he'd tried sound machines, he'd tried nutritional supplements. His hearing aids helped a little, but the tinnitus was still overwhelming. We added Lenire to his treatment plan. Lenire is a bimodal neuromodulation device approved by the FDA in 2023 to treat tinnitus. We also encouraged him to keep using his hearing aids. We also had him start doing mindfulness-based training, like deep breathing, relaxation, and neural retraining. And lastly, we added the biometric monitoring. The data revealed surprising patterns. Every afternoon, like clockwork, his heart rate variability would crash. When we asked him about it, he said it was exactly when his tinnitus felt the most intense, and it was that final push of his demanding workday. His previous tinnitus treatments had failed because they were generic. David did not need a sound machine 24/7, he needed a targeted intervention. So at 1:45 in the afternoon each day, right before his HRV would drop, he took a short 15-minute break to practice his calming techniques. The results were astounding. Over the next month, those afternoon HRV dips became shallower, then disappeared. His average HRV began to climb, an objective sign that his nervous system was recovering. But more importantly, David felt the difference. His tinnitus was no longer a monster, it was just a background noise and he felt in control. He could see the data, connect it to his actions, and he felt the result. That's the power of personalized, data-driven tinnitus care. The future of tinnitus treatment isn't about chasing some magic pill. It's about leaving behind the guesswork and embracing objective, personalized care. Biomarkers like heart rate variability are giving us unprecedented insight into the hidden physiology of tinnitus. This isn't about promising a silent cure, but something even more powerful. The tools, the insights, and the strategies to reduce your suffering and take your life back. If this way of thinking about tinnitus care resonates with you, click the link below to visit our website. If you're not in Utah, I'll also leave a link in the comments to help you find a modern tinnitus specialty center near you. Now, I want to hear from you. What have you tried to treat your tinnitus in the past, and did it work for you? Drop your story in the comments. Your experience could help someone else who's still searching for answers. And finally, if someone in your life is struggling with tinnitus, send this video their way. You never know whose life it can change. Want to learn more? Click the video on the screen above to learn about the top 3 science-backed treatments for tinnitus. I'm Dr. Layne Garrett. Thanks for being part of this movement towards a smarter, more personalized level of tinnitus care.